Hello, I'm Dave Slopsema from Dimensional Consulting. Today I'm going to talk about when to use the max material condition modifier and when to just leave it regardless of feature size. Many designers want to either use the M's everywhere or use them nowhere. Either way, it's a problem. Using the M's everywhere or using them nowhere is analogous to using commas everywhere or using commas nowhere. So for instance, if you're writing or you're talking, you probably would not say, let's, comma, eat, comma, grandma, comma. You'd never get through what you're trying to say. If you wrote that way, nobody would read it. Nobody could get through it. And you probably would not go to the other extreme and say, well, I'm just going to then leave out all the commas. And we'll say, let's eat grandma, because now grandma's life is in danger. Instead, you're going to take the trouble to learn when you should use commas and when you should not use commas. And you're going to say, let's eat, comma, grandma, and then you and grandma can have a nice meal together. It's the same way with the MMC modifier. If you use it everywhere, then it's going to cause quality problems for your company. Just bad things can happen. If you decide to use the MMC modifier nowhere, then you're going to cost your company extra money. It's really important to take the trouble to learn, when should I use the MMC modifier and when should I not? So, for example, we're going to take a look down here at a doghouse we may want to build. Our doghouse has a door and it has a window, and it has a little area in between where we're going to hang a sign. The sign is going to say no cats allowed. Now, where we hang the sign, we're going to have a couple of clearance holes, and then the sign will have a couple of clearance holes, and we'll line up the clearance holes in the sign with the clearance holes in the wall. And we'll put a couple of bolts through, put some nuts on the other side, and that's how we'll attach our sign. So let's take a look at what's appropriate in terms of MMC or RFS. As far as locating the door, it's kind of critical where it is, because if the door goes too far to the right, then you're not going to have enough room between the door and the window for your sign. If the door goes too far to the left, then you're going to get too close to the wall. Same thing with the window. If the window gets too close to the right, to the wall, you're not going to have enough room. It's going to fall off the side of the wall. If it gets too far to the left, you're not going to have enough room between the door and the window for the sign. Therefore, since we cannot tolerate the extra tolerance, the bonus tolerance that you get with MMC, we're going to call out the location of the window and the location of the door regardless of feature size. So we just don't put an M there, and then it's automatically regardless of feature size, according to rule number two. On the other hand, where we're going to have our clearance holes for the sign, the only thing we care about is assembly. We want to just take the sign, put it over the holes. We can move it around a little bit. As long as we can get our bolts through the holes, then we're going to be happy. So if these holes are made at their smallest allowable size of 0.9, we know that the bolts will go through the holes if we hold the location within 0.2. If the holes are made at 1 or at 1.1, they're bigger than their smallest allowable size, and they can be located a little farther off than 0.2, and we'll still be able to put the sign over there, line up bolts with holes, and get the bolts through. Therefore, we can handle the bonus tolerance, the extra tolerance of position. So we put the MMC modifier here because that helps us out. It makes it easier, maybe less expensive, to make our holes because they don't have to be as precise. So here are the windows, need to be precise. So we go with regardless of feature size. The holes don't need to be precise. They just need to be able to assemble. And so we can go with max material boundary is another matter. And that's when we put the M's here, the datums, datum callouts, and that's for another time. Let's take one little more look and talk about lease material condition. We talked about the fact that we want to preserve this distance between the side of the window and the side of the doghouse. That's what lease material condition is good for. Also preserving this distance between the window and the door, and the distance between the door and this side of the doghouse. Lease material condition is normally used for preserving a wall thickness or preserving some minimum distance. And so it really is appropriate to locate these windows with lease material condition. People tend to avoid lease material condition because they don't understand what it does. Regardless of feature size, it's certainly better than mass material condition here, but lease material condition would be the most functional way to do this because lease material condition preserves the minimum thickness here, the minimum space in between, and the minimum thickness here. So just in general, where do we use RFS and RMB? We use RFS and regardless of the material boundaries, which is when you put the M's by the datum references, on critical features where bonus tolerance or datum shift cannot be tolerated. We use RFS on threaded holes. Why do we use RFS on threaded holes? Because when you put the bolts in the bolts are going to automatically center themselves in the threads. Remember, max material condition gives you extra location tolerance. It takes advantage of slop in the system for assembly. But if the bolts are going to center themselves in the threads anyway, then there's no design advantage to having a bonus tolerance. Why would you allow extra location tolerance? Because the threads are a little bit bigger, a little smaller, when the bolts are still going to just center themselves in the threads. There's no advantage there. Also, holes used in press fits. If you have a hole and you're going to press fit a pin into it, if the hole is made at its largest allowable size, you're just going to have less press. But there's no advantage in assembly. So there's no reason to use an MMC modifier on a hole that's going to be used with a press fit. Holes used with axirads. Axirads are generally considered to center a bolt in the hole. Well, if it's going to center a bolt in the hole, then once again, there's no advantage of giving extra location tolerance for that hole if it's going to have an axirad in it, and it's going to center the bolt in the hole. If you have datums that are established by a gauge ball, sometimes you might have centers on the edge of a shaft, and you might have a gauge ball in that center, and you might actually make the gauge ball a datum. But the gauge ball theoretically has no sinus tolerance, so there's no way to reference it MMB. It's just perfect, so it's got to be regardless of feature size. We use MMC and MMB on non-critical features where the only thing we're concerned about is assembly. So the location is not so critical. We just want to have bolts line up with holes and go through holes and go into threaded holes. Now, sometimes you might put an MMC modifier on a threaded hole or maybe an MMB, a max material boundary modifier, because your threaded hole might be a datum. We said above that there is no design reason to do this. However, suppliers will sometimes ask you to put MMB or MMC on your threaded holes because they want to gauge those holes with a fixed gauge. And sometimes we make that accommodation. We say we'll do it even though there's no design advantage to it. However, if you do that, you need to, under your tolerance of position on your threaded hole, specify that the tolerance of position applies to the minor diameter. Because if you don't, then the tolerance of position applies to the pitch diameter, and that will not allow your supplier to use a fixed gauge. Your supplier can use a fixed gauge if you have your tolerance of position with the MMC modifier and the little note that says this tolerance of position applies to the minor diameter of the threads. And it's the same thing if you have holes where you're going to use axirads, but the supplier wants to use a fixed gauge to make sure the hole is in the right position. But just be careful here. You need to make sure that your design can tolerate the bonus tolerance or the datum feature shift. So think through before you agree to use MMC or MMB. And LMC and LMB, you do that where you want to maintain a minimum wall thickness or some other minimum distance. So I hope that helps. I hope I will see fewer drawings out there where there are either no M's or M's everywhere. We need to put our M's where they do some good and not put the M's where they're going to do some harm. So that's our tip for today. I hope you will visit my website at dimensionalconsulting.com, and thank you for your time.